Josh Buttler opening the batting for England T20 cricket. Been in fine form in the 50 overs. Had a really good Indian Premier League this year. Opened the batting six times for the Rajasthan Royals. Scored 550s. That's going to be four. The first boundary for Josh Buttler. Bit streaky.
Test here for Mitch Swepson. His first T20 game, international standard. He'll be excited by the fact that Buttler wants to take him on. He's in the game, Swepson.
Well, this is going to be a check upstairs. Sharp fielding, quick hands from Alex Carey. The Australians are convinced that Jason Roy's kind of stuck his bat in the ground.
Oh, he's got the foot in. He's all right. He's got in with the foot.
Catch. Oh, nicely played. Jason Roy. It's a full toss, but the execution of the reverse sweep is absolutely spot on. Josh Buttler down the ground. Mitchell Swepson on T20 debut. He's gone for 16 in his first over. Kane Richardson into the attack. And he's met with a boundary. Jason Roy has moved to 24 from 12 deliveries. It's 37 for naught after 3.1. That's gone high. Has it got long enough? Oh, yes. Yes, it has. It's the second six of the evening.
It's just an all-out assault on this Australian bowling lineup. Buttler, push off that 100, that match-winning 100.
Kane Richardson's first three balls have travelled. Have gone for 11 so far. Make that 15 from four. Well, England have struck 31 from the last nine deliveries. Make that 35 from 10.
Well, this is not bad bowling here. It's deceived the batsman, caught the big, thick outside edge. But it's a ruthless mindset by the English batsman, and they bring up 50, just 3.5 overs.
Oh, that's baseball style. It's over the top. And it's another boundary. Kane Richardson, welcome into the game. You've gone for 23. We're into the fifth over. And this is the fifth different bowler Australia have used. And it's Andrew Tai, probably the best of the T20 bowlers for Australia. Plenty of variations. Going to be out. Oh, it's dropped it. It's Kane Richardson. What a start to the game he's had. Travelled for 23, then drops an absolute goober.
Oh, this is heartbreaking for the Australians. Agar, it's a false stroke. He's just taken that a little bit too easy for mine. And he's out as quick as it went in. It's not good enough from the Australians.
Kane Richardson comes in on the one, and Buttler just whacks it over him. Butler's now 36 from 15, 5 fours, 2 sixes.
5.2 overs, and that's 12 boundaries already. Now on today, the Englishman.
Oh, that's huge. That's massive. Catch that in the crowd.
At 13 boundaries in 5.3 overs. This partnership just brewing, getting bigger and bigger. It's going to be a long 20 overs for the Australians.
That's going to be the first wicket. No, it's not. No, it's not. Big Billy just couldn't get past Jason Roy.
Well, it's tour for Australia is going from bad to worse. Just nothing going right. Big Billy, it's a tall frame. He beats Buttler for pace. Goes high, bottom of screen. Beautifully shielded by Jason Roy.
Well, I reckon VAR, that's a penalty. Ah, what a strike. That's going to be six. What a shot that is. He's on the back foot here, Josh Buttler.
90 miles an hour. This is courage. This is the modern day cricketer.
Now, what a shot that is. Just watch how far Buttler gets over to the offside. The bouncer comes and it brings up Josh Buttler's 50 from 22 deliveries. Six fours, four sixes. The quickest 50 that England have had in T20 cricket.
Moving around the crease. Another big one from Buttler. Never mind posting a long on, you don't need it.
This is just phenomenal hitting from Buttler again, advancing down, belting it. Didn't quite get it all, but comfortably sails over the man. And that's his fifth six already.
Oh, this one's got the treatment. Has he got enough on it, though? No, comfortably taken at head height. And a first international wicket for Mitchell Swepson. Delight for him. More importantly, Australia have got rid of Josh Buttler. A tremendous innings from him. The crowd have been thrilled. The quickest 2020 international 50 by an England batsman. But he's holed out. And for Australia, they will breathe a huge sigh of relief as Darcy Short took that catch.
Phenomenal knock from Josh Buttler. Deserves all those applause. He made 61 off 30 balls. England 95 for one.
Up and over. Four more for Jason Roy. Scoring rapidly. Brings up the England 102.
Beautiful shot from Jason Roy, showing his power and his form that he's got at the minute.
Oh, here's a quick second. What a wayward throw, a really wayward throw. Four more, thank you very much indeed. Oh dear, the debutant. Well, actually, he chose the right end to go to, but certainly needed to be on the stumps. Oh, high in the sky. Here's a chance. Steadying underneath it. And the captain, Aaron Finch, takes the catch. Two down now, England. Got rid of both openers. Roy gone. Buttler gone, but they've done some great work with the bat first.
Yeah, good from Big Billy Stanlake, banging it into the surface. Change of length, surprise Jason Roy, and a very comfortable catch from Aaron Finch. Great platform for England. Jason Roy has to go for 44. England 108 for two.
Oh, launched over the leg side. Last ball of the 10th over, and Owen Morgan crashes his first six of the innings. England at the halfway stage, 116 runs on the board. Morgan's coming up the order ahead of Alex Hales, who he's batting with now. But Morgan came in at three, and he's just picked that one up beautifully.
So 116 for two at halfway.
So England 116 for two after 10 overs. Five of those 10 have gone for more than 12 runs. England, if they carry on going as they are looking well set to break their own highest 2020 international total. More from Edgbaston after the break. Welcome back to Edgbaston. Owen Morgan and Alex Hales at the crease for England. They're already 116 for two, still 10 overs to go in the innings. Oh, carved away. Four for Hales. This outfield is so fast. He owns three of the highest scores in England 2020 international history. All as an opener, he's come in here at four. Full toss, smacked away. Nobody on the boundary there. Morgan, four more for England.
Yeah, and that's Kane Richardson. He's gone for 34 in 10 deliveries already. Australia have been poor.
Reverse attempt, skipped it high in the air there. Misjudgment from Morgan, and the catch taken comfortably. Oh, Swepson's got two on his international debut. Couple of big scalps as well. Morgan the latest to go.
Yeah, it's a real strength of Morgan's. Obviously premeditated early, short delivery from Swepson. All he could do was pick out Andrew Tai. Safe catch in the end, and Australia in need a few more of them. Morgan goes for 15, England 132 for three.
Picker from Agar, launched down the ground. Alex Hales, plenty on that. Brilliant ball striking, the crowd love it. Even the kangaroo loves it.
Yeah, it's a real feature of Alex Hales, is batting those long levers. Big extension of the arms and power behind it as well. It's gone all the way.
Oh, delicately played, no third man. Second boundary for Alex Hales, England approaching the 150 mark.
Yeah, he's renowned for his power hitting, but lovely touch from Hales. Yet again, too much width from Australia.
Joe Root, 9 from 9, needs a boundary. Make that 9 from 10. Now, Johnny Bairstow's waiting in the hutch. With the form that he showed, you could easily have pushed Johnny just one higher up the order. That's going to be his first boundary. Perfect placement.
That's his go-to shot, the slog sweep, and he certainly needed that boundary.
That's a bit streaky from Joe Root. Another boundary nonetheless. Kane Richardson, just look at these figures. 2.1 overs, 0 for 39. Oh, another edge, another boundary. Joe Root scoring fours off the edge. And another edge, and another four. Richardson now's gone for 49 in 2.4. I think he's hit the ground with the bat. Not out, says Alex Worth. Now, Australia have one review. Alex Carey's, right, we'll go for it. Pretty sure he also said that he thinks Alex Hales hit the ground. He's hit the ground with the bat. As Alex Carey behind the stump said, good decision from Alex Worth, the umpire. Australia lose their review. Powerful struck down the ground, the boundaries aren't huge. The 50 partnership and 28 deliveries. 24 seven sixes.
Yeah, that's brutal power from Alex Hales. That's his 4-4. Too much power for these Australian bowlers.
Oh, that's high. That's high. And that's massive. That's the first tier of this tremendous new stand here at Edgbaston. Alex Hales is 42 from 19 deliveries. We've already seen the record from Josh Buttler today. Can Alex Hales break it? Oh, brilliant from Joe Root. Just the change in the back grip. getting square onto the bowler, just getting enough on it. He's liking that third man region. Oh, brilliant again from an England batsman. Innovation at its best. You don't see this that often from Alex Hales. He generally strikes it down the ground. Watch the way he gets over to the offside, gets down low early. And on release of the ball, he's very still. Watch this. Still on the release. Gives him chance to get those levers going. The 200 up for England. Marcus Stoinis comes in for his first ball. The 19th over. And what a catch, what a wicket. Where's he been hiding?
Well, that's a remarkable catch from Stoinis. In his follow through, had enough composure to grab it in his right hand. Short delivery, dug into the surface. That is a ridiculous catch. Take a bow, Marcus Stoinis. Alex Hales, 49 of 24 balls, England 204 for 4.
Johnny Bairstow straight into the action. Six. First ball.
He hits it as hard as anybody. He doesn't waste any time to get going. That was in the slot. First ball. Gone into the stands.
Just two from the first four deliveries of Andrew Tide. Make that two from five in the last over. There's going to be a run out, both at the same end. Brilliant bowling from Andrew Tide. Lots of variations, doing for Johnny Bairstow. And it's Joe Root that'll be on his way. Johnny threw the shot too soon. Joe Root takes on the single. Johnny didn't want to go. He jumps back into his crease. He's saying, sorry, Joe, I want to strike it last ball, not you. There you go, watch this. No, I'm getting in. It's like being at school again. In. Joe Root has to go for 35. It's 2-on-5 for 5. And the last ball of the innings. And the last ball's going into Birmingham Town Centre. That's a huge one, the biggest of the night. England end on 221.
Yet again, that was in the slot from Andrew Tye. That was his knuckleball in the slot for Johnny Bairstow. Shows his power again, and that has gone a long way back.
Well, that's why he wanted the last ball, Bairstow. England's second highest T20 score, 221 for 5, and there was contributions all down that batting lineup. Royan Buttler, brilliant at the top. Little cameo from Morgan, he changed his position in the order. Hales and Joe Root manoeuvred the ball to 360 degrees around the ground.
Tough day at the office for Australia's bowlers. Flat surface, quick outfield, small boundaries. Agar again, the standout bowler. Those figures and those economies aren't pretty reading.
So there you have it. Australia required 222 to win this only T20 contest. The rate requires 11.1. We'll have the chase after the break.
Well, that's a flashy start there. Darcy Short up against David Willey. They'll know each other from Big Bash challenges, but it's a little bit loose there from Short. Slip taken out, Willie. That's far too straight. Work to the leg side. Jordan does some great work down there on the boundary and keeps it to two. It's the all-round talents, Chris Jordan there. It's not just with ball or bat in hand. It's a complete cricketer. Steady start for the Australians. Jordan working into it and work to the leg side well. Darcy Short. It was straight. It was quick bat speed. Picks off the first boundary. Oh, that's two straight as well from Jordan. And it's good batting. Darcy Short It's the second boundary, consecutive balls, and what a way to silence 24,000 people in this ground here.
Yeah, you can see what Jordan's trying to do. He's trying to get the ball very straight to restrict Darcy short of any width on the offside.
Oh, beautiful stroke, Darcy short. It's your more traditional cricket shot. It's the overcompensation from Jordan. It's been too straight, got picked for a couple of boundaries, this time through the offside. Oh, taken it short, fine leg. Liam Plunkett into the attack. His second ball, immediate impact.
Oh, I think Darcy Short will be disappointed with this because you'd rather him get out really having a go and trying to whack it into the stands. This is a nothing shot, really. The cutter from Liam Plunkett. Simple catch from Moeen Ali. The Australians lose their first wicket. Darcy Short goes for 16. It's 17 for one.
Oh, Aaron Finch getting in on the act now. It was a good over from Plunkett. It got the wicket. Finch's creativity brought about a boundary off the last ball after three overs, 24 for one. Free hit. There's a man at third man and deep backward square. Maxwell carves it down the ground. Oh, you can play with freedom there. Is that the ball that launches this attack for the Aussies? Bowled him! The change of pace. Jordan gets the last laugh. Maxwell goes.
Well, 65 miles an hour. A great disguise from Jordan. Things like a back spinner. It's an absolute beauty. And the key Maxwell is on his way back to the pavilion.
That's clever bowling, Chris Jordan. Just delivered the no ball. Free hit for the four, but comes back. Maxwell goes 10 off 7. Australia in trouble, 33 for 2. Travis Head is the new man. And this could be trouble. Oh, he's going to get away with a five. Well, what looked like potentially a close run out, you're off the mark with a five.
Well, watch this from David Willey. He gets a free direct aim at the stumps. And I reckon he misses them from, watch this, into the hand. Perfect position to throw it. And he misses the stumps. But look at that, he misses by 2 metres.
Oh, that's worked nicely by Travis Head. Too straight from Plunkett. That's protection. That man out in the deep, he's more around square leg, worked nicely behind, used the pace. It's the sixth boundary.
Two balls for Travis Head. He's on 9.
Well struck. Aaron Finch, he's just been a little bit frustrated. He was 7 off 7 deliveries, but finally creates something. It was just brute force dispatched over the top from David Willey. Well, that's nicely worked by Finch to the leg side. A little bit wayward there, David Willey. 12 off the over, and Australia just complete their power play with a bit of momentum, 59 for 2. It's been a great start here, Adil Rashid. The first use of spin, just 3 runs from the over into the gap. They'll push to try and get back for 2, but no, well done. Out in the deep by Jordan. It's a good start for the spinner. Just 4 off at 63 for 2.
Oh, this could be a chance. Comfortably taken. Alex Hales with the catch, and Moeen Ali gets a wicket. The first over that he's been brought on. Spin from both ends has brought a bit of pressure, added pressure. And Australia in more trouble, 64 for 3.
Again, just like the ODIs, it's England's spinners doing the damage. Moeen Ali's just been brought into the attack. Travis Head trying to give himself a little bit of room to create the width and elevation straight to Alex Hales. Another big wicket for England. Australia 64 for 3.
Very delicately played by Aaron Finch, showing he's got the delicate touch as well as the big hits. He is an important batsman for Australia at this point. Could be the real anchor for their innings. Could be very dangerous if he's still there towards the end.
He's usually renowned for his power hitting. Lovely deft little touch, beating the man at 45 on his way to the boundary.
Short-lived, and Adam Rashid picks up his first wicket of this match. A highly thought of left-hander, Alex Carey. Got an opportunity at Old Trafford in the one-day series. Touch of turn off the pitch from Adam Rashid. And Australia, well, the situation gets even deeper. 72 for 4. Australia from here still will need another 150 from 70 balls. It's a tough ask. More from Edgbaston as Australia chase down 2-2-2 after the break. Welcome back then to Edgbaston, where Australia have lost four wickets in pursuit of 222. They've still got Aaron Finch there. He is a real danger man, but he is rapidly running out of partners as Marcus Stoinis comes out to join him. Roy with the catch, two in the over from Adil Rashid. Crowder enjoying it, Australia very much less so, but England can celebrate. Stoinis gone cheaply, out for a duck.
Yeah, his poor form continues, doesn't he? Couldn't get the elevation. And a simple catch to Jason Roy, and England's go-to man Adil Rashid does it again. Australia 72 for 5.
Oh, he's gone huge. Aaron Finch over deep mid-wicket. First six. And Australia need a few more of those. The run rate is above 13 and an over from here.
Yeah, that's what you're used to seeing from Aaron Finch. Give himself a room to free those arms. Absolutely belting.
Well, we've already featured Pakistan, Australia and Scotland for you on Channel 5 Cricket this summer. Now Virat Kohli's India are in town. Three 2020 internationals and a series win for England could really help them to climb the rankings there. Then the one-day internationals, and that is number 1v2 in the world. So a tantalising series before five test matches against India wrap up the summer season. Highlights every day on Channel 5. Launched, no question. Ashton Agar, new to the middle. And he has just picked up Adil Rashid beautifully. Hasn't always done well against the spin. In fact, Rashid has dismissed him four times out of five in the one-day internationals. Oh, this is massive. Massive from Aaron Finch. Have Australia got enough time, though, here in this match? They need more than 14 and over. The required rate keeps going up. But suddenly the sixes are starting to happen for the Aussies.
Yeah, that's Aaron Finch's second six. And that is well and truly in his arc. Absolutely pummeled.
Oh, thrashed down the ground by Aaron Finch. So much power on it. Meant that Chris Jordan couldn't get there. They've gone past the 100 mark, Australia, but five down and the run rate ever increasing. Aaron Finch is doing his best to bring it down. Oh, high and long. That one reaches the stands. Possibly well caught as well. What a way to bring up your 50. Aaron Finch does it off 27 balls. Australia's still got a glimmer of hope. I reckon they have when this man is in the middle.
Well played, Aaron Finch. Picked up the length beautifully. No knows that Moeen Ali with this field has to bowl into length, and that's his third six. That's gone miles.
Up and over. Well, Aaron Finch has welcomed Liam Plunkett back into the attack in the most emphatic way. We've had five sixes in just the last 10 minutes. Boundaries are starting to come, the sixes are starting to come on all off the bat of Aaron Finch. Well, that's been finally struck by Agar. Plenty of power on the shot, get it through the gap.
Yeah, excellent stroke that from Agar, hitting the ball on top of his bounce through the offside. Great stroke.
Oh, Agar down the ground. They're doing their best to bring the run rate down. It's still sitting at more than 14 and over, though. Oh, full toss, heaved away. No questions asked. Six all the way.
These two have put on 62 now, and that's Aaron Finch's fifth six.
Boy, he's just leant back, battered it back down the ground. Sheer muscle from Finch. Moving up through the gears. Oh, massive again. Aaron Finch is into the 70s and he is looking good for 100. Incredible striking. 22 runs have just come off that over from Moeen Ali.
Last in there goes 21 from 16. And he's striking them very nicely. It could be four more. Yes, it is. This game is on for Australia.
Remember a 99 World Cup match here, a bloke called Lance Klusner hit a few out in that area, 40, in an extraordinary game of cricket. This has gone at similar pace, and it's going to be an important role from Ashton Agar. If Australia are going to get home, it's expectations Finch will be the man. Well done there, finding the boundary.
Oh, it's power again from Aaron Finch. It's on a plate from Adil Rashid this time. 84 from 40 for Finch.
Just like the way he's staying really still. Look at that nice foundation, nice base.
Well, that's tossed up. Gone high, it's Jordan under it. Great pair of hands, it's a good catch, and that could be game over. Rashid gets his third.
Courageous bowling, Adil Rashid. Taking pace off, just tempting Finch, challenging. He knows he needs to keep finding the road, but he couldn't get there. He was flighted, and the eyes lit up. He was right in the slot, just cut across it a little bit. It was a really well-judged catch down there. Jordan, he knew exactly where he was in relation to that boundary line. Well played, Aaron Finch. 84 off just 41. Australia, I think they're in trouble now, 158 for six.
Oh, Andrew Tyne to the action, second ball into the stands. We've seen some sixes tonight. 18 sixes this evening. Just five runs from this David Willey over. 50 required from 19 deliveries for Australia. Make that 49 from the last three overs. Magnificent bowling from Willey. Just the six runs from it. Got him. Full and straight. Agar walking across to the offside and flick it down past fine leg. And he just misses it.
Terrific bowling. Chris Jordan stepping into a successful one-day team. They've got all their momentum and energy up. It's a, could be a challenge coming in just for these one-off games, but he's brought his energy, his enthusiasm, and he gets the job done. The danger man goes. Agar, 29 off 23, 174 for 7.
Kane Richardson. And he's out first ball. Well, if there was any one of those days, Kane Richardson, 0 for 59 with the ball. He dropped to Goober, and he's out first ball.
And throw a little misfield in there too, Vaughan. So, yeah, not the ideal day at the office for Kane Richardson. Well done. It's Jordan. No other option, really. So credit to Richardson that he didn't get selfish. He tried to do the team thing, but 3 wickets for Jordan. Yeah, the smiles are big. And he's on a hat-trick. The Golden Duck, 174 for 8.
Mitchell Sweps in at number 10. Jordan on a hat-trick. And he did the right thing, full and straight. Two runs and 2 wickets from this Chris Jordan over. 3 for 14, 3.5. And it's a good finish. The 3 wickets are the key for Chris Jordan. He goes for 42. Australia required 45 from the last 2 overs. Ah, that's high and handsome from Andrew Tai. That's straight down the barrel.
I don't think it's going to affect the result. A little bit of fun here for AJ Tai. David Willey doesn't see it that way, but it was pace on right in the slot, arch the back. That's a golf swing.
And again. This time he's going to be out. Liam Plunkett right on the edge. Willie with his first wicket of the night.
9 down now, Australia. One more for England. Really well-judged catch. Liam Plunkett, tall man. Just knew exactly where he was in relation to that boundary. Well struck by AJ Tai. Just put one right up in the upper deck. That's a good catch, David Willey. It's a breakthrough. Australia, 184 for 9.
That's going to be game over. Plunkett finishes it for England. Tremendous performance. The captain takes the grab.
Yet another brilliant display by this England team in white ball cricket. So well led, Owen Morgan. It's appropriate that he takes the catch to close it out. It's just another all-round wonderful effort. Everyone chipping in. Brilliant crowd in over 24,000. Wonderful scenes. It's a family game. There's grandparents and grandchildren and everyone in between come and enjoy 2020 cricket. And why not when you can watch a team like England has at the moment?
Well, England are just a powerhouse in the white ball game. They've got pretty much everything covered. They put on a great show, a really good team to watch, play the game the right way. It's been a wonderful night's entertainment.
Here's the tale of the tape. The batting for Australia. Short went early Finch. He finally found his range, and that was a very good innings, but no one really was able to support him. And it always looked like it was a step too far. Big total, 193 all out in the bowling.
Well, all the bowlers managed to get a wicket. He's just got good variations, Owen Morgan, the captain. Moeen Ali had a difficult night. Aaron Finch got hold of him, his economy being 14.5. But the look of Rashid goes for 6.75 once again. And there's the end result. England win the series 1-0 and win this game by 28 runs. Billy Stanlake to get things started for Australia. To Jason Roy. Straight away, he's going to start with a boundary. What a lovely stroke that is.
Oh, well, the carnage continues from the one days for the Aussies. Well, they've started just with the one slip and the short mid-wicket there. You could see him there sneaking in, but look at the wrist work from Jason Roy. Lent on it. So what's the way he gets over the top of this? Holds the shot. Four runs to start proceedings. Wow.
Well, it looks a beautiful surface to have a bat on. It's dry. No rough follow-throughs at all. These white balls aren't swinging, so you'd expect the batsman to cash in tonight. That's why you see shots like that. Two fours in three balls.
I think Jason Roy's biggest challenge today is going to be holding himself back, Vaughnie, because you've described it. That wicket is a beauty. Perfect cricket conditions. And the ball coming on. He's creative. Didn't get all of it. Look out. If he does, it's going to travel.
Four more. He hits a four every odd number. First ball, third ball, fifth ball. Josh Buttler opening the batting for England T20 cricket. Been in fine form in the 50 overs. Had a really good Indian Premier League this year. Opened the batting six times for the Rajasthan Royals. Scored 550s. That's going to be four. The first boundary for Josh Buttler. Bit streaky.
Test here for Mitch Swepson. His first T20 game, international standard. He'll be excited by the fact that Buttler wants to take him on. He's in the game, Swepson.
Well, this is going to be a check upstairs. Sharp fielding, quick hands from Alex Carey. The Australians are convinced that Jason Roy's kind of stuck his bat in the ground.
Oh, he's got the foot in. He's all right. He's got in with the foot.
Catch. Oh, nicely played. Jason Roy. It's a full toss, but the execution of the reverse sweep is absolutely spot on. Josh Buttler down the ground. Mitchell Swepson on T20 debut. He's gone for 16 in his first over. Kane Richardson into the attack. And he's met with a boundary. Jason Roy has moved to 24 from 12 deliveries. It's 37 for naught after 3.1. That's gone high. Has it got long enough? Oh, yes. Yes, it has. It's the second six of the evening.
It's just an all-out assault on this Australian bowling lineup. Buttler, push off that 100, that match-winning 100.
Kane Richardson's first three balls have travelled. They've gone for 11 so far. Make that 15 from four. England have struck 31 from the last nine deliveries. Make that 35 from 10.
Well, this is not bad bowling here. It's deceived the batsman, caught the big thick outside edge. But it's a ruthless mindset by the English batsman, and they bring up 50, just 3.5 overs.
Oh, that's baseball style. It's over the top. And it's another boundary. Kane Richardson, welcome into the game. You've gone for 23. Well, we're into the fifth over. And this is the fifth different bowler Australia have used. And it's Andrew Tye, probably the best of the T20 bowlers for Australia. Plenty of variations. Going to be out. Oh, he's dropped it. It's Kane Richardson. What a start to the game he's had. Travelled for 23, then drops an absolute goober.
Oh, this is heartbreaking for the Australians. Agar, it's a false stroke. He's just taken that a little bit too easy for mine. And he's out as quick as it went in. It's not good enough from the Australians.
Kane Richardson comes in on the one, and Buttler just whacks it over him. Butler's now 36 from 15. 5 fours, 2 sixes.
5.2 overs, and that's 12 boundaries already. Now, on today, the Englishman.
Oh, that's huge. That's massive. Catch that in the crowd.
At 13 boundaries in 5.3 overs. This partnership just brewing, getting bigger and bigger. It's going to be a long 20 overs for the Australians.
That's going to be the first wicket. No, it's not. No, it's not. Big Billy just couldn't get past Jason Roy.
Well, this tour for Australia is going from bad to worse. Just nothing going right. Big Billy, it's a tall frame. He beats Buttler for pace. Goes high, bottom of screen. Beautifully shielded by Jason Roy.
Well, I reckon VAR, that's a penalty. Ah, what a strike. That's going to be six. What a shot that is. He's on the back foot here, Josh Buttler.
90 miles an hour. This is courage. This is the modern day cricketer.
Now, what a shot that is. Just watch how far Buttler gets over to the offside. The bouncer comes and it brings up Josh Buttler's 50 from 22 deliveries. 6 fours, 4 sixes. The quickest 50 that England have had in T20 cricket.
Moving around the crease. Another big one from Buttler. Never mind posting a long on, you don't need it.
This is just phenomenal hitting from Buttler again, advancing down. Belting it, didn't quite get it all, but comfortably sails over the van. And that's his fifth six already.
Oh, this one's got the treatment. Has he got enough on it though? No, comfortably taken at head height. And a first international wicket for Mitchell Swepson. Delight for him. More importantly, Australia have got rid of Josh Buttler. A tremendous innings from him. The crowd have been thrilled. The quickest 2020 international 50 by an England batsman. He's holed out. And for Australia, they will breathe a huge sigh of relief as Darcy Short took that catch.
Phenomenal knock from Josh Buttler, deserves all those applause. He made 61 off 30 balls. England 95 for one.
Up and over, four more for Jason Roy. Scoring rapidly. Brings up the England 102.
Yeah, beautiful shot from Jason Roy, showing his power and his form that he's got at the minute.
Here's a quick second. What a wayward throw. A really wayward throw. Four more. Thank you very much indeed. Oh dear, the debutant. Actually, he chose the right end to go to, but certainly needed to be on the stumps. Oh, high in the sky. Here's a chance. Steadying underneath it. And the captain, Aaron Finch, takes the catch. Two down now, England. Got rid of both openers. Roy gone, Buttler gone. but they've done some great work with the bat first.
Yeah, good from Big Billy Stanlake, banging it into the surface. Change of length, surprise Jason Roy, and a very comfortable catch from Aaron Finch. Great platform for England. Jason Roy has to go for 44. England 108 for two.
Oh, launched over the leg side. Last ball of the 10th over, and Owen Morgan crashes his first six of the innings. England at the halfway stage, 116 runs on the board. Morgan's coming up the order ahead of Alex Hales, who he's batting with now. But Morgan came in at three, and he's just picked that one up beautifully.
So, 16 for two at halfway.
So England 116 for two after 10 overs. Five of those 10 have gone for more than 12 runs. England, if they carry on going as they are looking well set to break their own highest 2020 international total. More from Edgbaston after the break. Welcome back to Edgbaston. Owen Morgan and Alex Hales at the crease for England. They're already 116 for two, still 10 overs to go in the innings. Oh, carved away. Four for Hales. This outfield is so fast. He owns three of the highest scores in England 2020 international history. All as an opener, he's come in here at four. Full toss. Smacked away. Nobody on the boundary there. Morgan, four more for England.
Yeah, and that's Kane Richardson. He's gone for 34 in 10 deliveries already. Australia have been poor.
Reverse attempt, skipped it high in the air there, misjudgment from Morgan, and the catch taken comfortably. Oh, Swepson's got two on his international debut. Couple of big scalps as well. Morgan the latest to go.
Yeah, it's a real strength of Morgan's, obviously premeditated the early short delivery from Swepson. All he could do was pick out Andrew Tai, safe catch in the end, and Australia in need a few more of them. Morgan goes for 15, England 132 for three.
Picker from Agar, launched down the ground. Alex Hales plenty on that. Brilliant ball striking, the crowd love it. Even the kangaroo loves it.
Yeah, it's a real feature of Alex Hales is batting those long levers. Big extension of the arms and power behind it as well. It's gone all the way.
Oh, delicately played, no third man. Second boundary for Alex Hales, England approaching the 150 mark.
Yeah, he's renowned for his power hitting, but lovely touch from Hales. Yet again, too much width from Australia.
Joe Root, 9 from 9, needs a boundary. Make that 9 from 10. Now, Johnny Bairstow's waiting in the hutch. With the form that he showed, you could easily have pushed Johnny just one higher up the order. That's going to be his first boundary. Perfect placement.
That's his go-to shot, the slog sweep, and he certainly needed that boundary.
That's a bit streaky from Joe Root. Another boundary nonetheless. Kane Richardson, just look at these figures. 2.1 overs, 0 for 39. Oh, another edge, another boundary. Joe Root scoring fours off the edge. And another edge, and another four. Richardson now's gone for 49 in 2.4. Yeah. I think he's hit the ground with the bat. Not out, says Alex Worth. Now, Australia have one review. Alex Carey's, all right, we'll go for it. Pretty sure he also said that he thinks Alex Hales hit the ground. He's hit the ground with the bat. As Alex Carey behind the stump said, Good decision from Alex Worth, the umpire. Australia lose their review. Powerful struck down the ground, the boundaries aren't huge. The 50 partnership and 28 deliveries. 24 seven sixes.
Yeah, that's brutal power from Alex Hales. That's his 4-4. Too much power for these Australian bowlers.
Oh, that's high. That's high. And that's massive. That's the first tier of this tremendous new stand here at Edgbaston. Alex Hales is 42 from 19 deliveries. We've already seen the record from Josh Buttler today. Can Alex Hales break it? Oh, brilliant from Joe Root. Just the change in the back grip. Getting square onto the bowler, just getting enough on it. He's liking that third man region. Oh, brilliant again from an England batsman. Innovation at its best. You don't see this that often from Alex Hales. He generally strikes it down the ground. Much the way he gets over to the offside, gets down low early. And on release of the ball, he's very still. Watch this, still on the release. Gives him chance to get those levers going. The 200 up for England. Marcus Stoinis comes in for his first ball, the 19th over. And what a catch, what a wicket. Where's he been hiding?
Well, that's a remarkable catch from Stoinis. Dennis follow through, had enough composure to grab it in his right hand. Short delivery, dug into the surface. That is a ridiculous catch. Take a bow, Marcus Stoinis. Alex Hales, 49 of 24 balls. England, 204 for 4.
Johnny Bairstow straight into the action. Six. First ball.
He hits it as hard as anybody. He doesn't waste any time to get going. That was in the slot. First ball. Got into the stands.
Just two from the first four deliveries of Andrew Tide. Make that two from five in the last over. There's going to be a run out, both at the same end. Brilliant bowling from Andrew Tye. Lots of variations doing for Johnny Bairstow. And it's Joe Root that'll be on his way. Johnny threw the shot too soon. Joe Root takes on the single. Johnny didn't want to go. He jumps back into his crease. He's saying, sorry, Joe, I want to strike it last ball, not you. There you go, watch this. No, I'm getting in. It's like being at school again. In. Joe Root has to go for 35. It's 2-1-5 for 5. And the last ball of the innings. And the last ball's going into Birmingham Town Centre. That's a huge one, the biggest of the night. England end on 221.
Yet again, that was in the slot from Andrew Tye. That was his knuckleball in the slot for Johnny Bairstow. Shows his power again, and that has gone a long way back.
Well, that's why he wanted the last ball, Bairstow. England's second highest T20 score, 221 for five, and there was contributions all down that batting line. At Royan Buttler, brilliant at the top. Little cameo from Morgan, he changed his position in the order. Hales and Joe Root manoeuvred the ball to 360 degrees around the ground.
Tough day at the office for Australia's bowlers. Flat surface, quick outfield, small boundaries. Agar again, the standout bowler. Those figures and those economies aren't pretty reading.
So there you have it. Australia required 222 to win this only T20 contest. The rate requires 11.1. We'll have the chase after the break. A
Well, that's a flashy start there. Darcy Short up against David Willey. They'll know each other from Big Bash challenges, but it's a little bit loose there from Short. Slip taken out, Willey. That's far too straight. Work to the leg side. Jordan does some great work down there on the boundary and keeps it to two. It's the all-round talents, Chris Jordan there. It's not just with ball or bat in hand. It's a complete cricketer. Just been a steady start for the Australians. Jordan working into it and work to the leg side well. Darcy Short. It was straight. It was quick bat speed. Picks off the first boundary. Oh, that's two straight as well from Jordan, and it's good batting, Darcy Short. It's the second boundary, consecutive balls, and what a way to silence 24,000 people in this ground here.
Yeah, you can see what Jordan's trying to do. He's trying to get the ball very straight to restrict Darcy Short of any width on the offside.
Oh, beautiful stroke, Darcy Short. It's your more traditional cricket shot. It's overcompensation from Jordan. It's been two straight, got picked for a couple of boundaries, this time through the offside. Oh, taken at short fine leg. Liam Plunkett into the attack. His second ball, immediate impact.
Oh, I think Darcy Short will be disappointed with this because you'd rather him get out really having a go and trying to whack it into the stands. This is a nothing shot, really. The cutter from Liam Plunkett. Simple catch from Moeen Ali. The Australians lose their first wicket. Darcy Short goes for 16. It's 17 for one.
Oh, Aaron Finch getting in on the act now. It was a good over from Plunkett. It got the wicket. Finch's creativity brought about a boundary off the last ball after three overs, 24 for one. Free hit. There's a man at third man and deep backward square. Maxwell carves it down the ground. Well, you can play with freedom there. Is that the ball that launches this attack for the Aussies? Change of pace. Jordan gets the last laugh. Maxwell goes.
Well, 65 miles an hour. A great disguise from Jordan. Things like a back spinner. It's an absolute beauty. And the key, Maxwell, is on his way back to the pavilion.
That's clever bowling. Chris Jordan just delivered the no ball. Free hit for the four, but comes back. Maxwell goes 10 off 7. Australia in trouble, 33 for 2. Travis Head is the new man. And this could be trouble. Oh, he's going to get away with a 5. Well, what looked like potentially a close run out, you're off the mark with a 5.
Well, watch this from David Willey. He gets a free direct aim at the stumps. And I reckon he misses them from, watch this, into the hand. Perfect position to throw it. And he misses the stumps. But look at that, he misses by 2 metres.
Well, that's worked nicely by Travis Head. Too straight from Plunkett. That's protection. That man out in the deep, he's more around square leg, worked nicely behind, used the pace. It's the sixth boundary.
Two balls for Travis Head. He's on 9.
Well struck. Aaron Finch. He's just been a little bit frustrated. He was 7 off 7 deliveries, but finally creates something. It was just brute force. Dispatched over the top from David Willey. Well, that's nicely worked by Finch to the leg side. A little bit wayward there, David Willey. 12 off the over, and Australia just complete their power play with a bit of momentum. 59 for 2. It's been a great start here. Adil Rashid, the first use of spin, just 3 runs from the over into the gap. They'll push to try and get back for 2, but no, well done. Out in the deep by Jordan. It's a good start for the spinner. Just 4 off at 63 for 2.
Oh, this could be a chance. Comfortably taken. Alex Hales with the catch, and Moeen Ali gets a wicket. The first over that he's been brought on. Spin from both ends has brought a bit of pressure, added pressure. And Australia in more trouble. 64 for 3.
Again, just like the ODIs, it's England's spinners doing the damage. Moeen Ali's just been brought into the attack. Travis Head trying to give himself a little bit of room to create the width and elevation. Straight to Alex Hales. Another big wicket for England. Australia 64 for 3.
Oh, very delicately played by Aaron Finch. Showing he's got the delicate touch as well as the big hits. He is an important batsman for Australia at this point. Could be the real anchor for their innings. Could be very dangerous if he's still there towards the end.
He's usually renowned for his power hitting. Lovely deft little touch, beating the man at 45. His way to the boundary.
The new batsman is stay. The crease is very short-lived. And Adil Rashid picks up his first wicket of this match. A highly thought of left-hander, Alex Carey. Got an opportunity at Old Trafford in the one-day series. Touch of turn off the pitch from Adil Rashid. And Australia, well, the situation gets even deeper. 72 for 4. Australia from here still need another 150 from 70 balls. It's a tough ask. More from Edgbaston as Australia chase down 222 after the break. Welcome back then to Edgbaston, where Australia have lost 4 wickets in pursuit of 222. They've still got Aaron Finch there. He is a real danger man, but he is rapidly running out of partners as Marcus Stoinis comes out to join him. Jason Roy with the catch. 2 in the over from Adil Rashid. Crowder enjoying it. Australia very much less so. But England can celebrate. Stoinis gone cheaply. Out for a duck.
Yeah, his poor form continues, doesn't he? Couldn't get the elevation. And a simple catch to Jason Roy. And England's go-to man, Adil Rashid, does it again. Australia 72 for 5.
Oh, he's gone huge. Aaron Finch over deep mid-wicket. First 6. And Australia need a few more of those. The run rate is above 13 and an over from here.
Yeah, that's what you're used to seeing from Aaron Finch. Giving himself a room to free those arms. Absolutely belting.
Well, we've already featured Pakistan, Australia and Scotland for you on Channel 5 Cricket this summer. Now, Virat Kohli's India are in town. 3 2020 internationals and a series win for England could really help them to climb the rankings there. Then the one-day internationals, and that is number 1v2 in the world. So a tantalising series before 5 test matches against India wrap up the summer season. Highlights every day on Channel 5. Launched, no question. Ashton Agar, new to the middle. And he has just picked up Adil Rashid beautifully. Hasn't always done well against the spin. In fact, Rashid has dismissed him 4 times out of 5 in the one-day internationals. Oh, this is massive. Massive from Aaron Finch. Have Australia got enough time, though, here in this match? They need more than 14 and over. The required rate keeps going up. But suddenly the sixes are starting to happen for the Aussies.
Yeah, that's Aaron Finch's second six. And that is well and truly in his arc. Absolutely pummeled.
Oh, thrashed down the ground by Aaron Finch. So much power on it that Chris Jordan couldn't get there. They've gone past the 100 mark, Australia, but five down and the run rate ever increasing. Aaron Finch is doing his best to bring it down. Oh, high and long. That one reaches the stands. Possibly well caught as well. What a way to bring up your 50. Aaron Finch does it off 27 balls. Australia's still got a glimmer of hope. I reckon they have when this man is in the middle.
Well played, Aaron Finch. Picked up the length beautifully. No, knows that Moeen Ali with this field has to bowl into length. And that's his third six. That's gone miles.
Up and over. Well, Aaron Finch has welcomed Liam Plunkett back into the attack in the most emphatic way. We've had five sixes in just the last 10 minutes. Boundaries are starting to come, the sixes are starting to come. And all off the bat of Aaron Finch. Well, that's been finally struck by Agar. Plenty of power on the shot. It through the gap.
Yeah, excellent stroke that from Agar, hitting the ball on top of his bounce through the offside. Great stroke.
Oh, Agar down the ground. Well, they're doing their best to bring the run rate down. It's still sitting at more than 14 and over though. Oh, full toss, heaved away. No questions asked. Six all the way.
These two have put on 62 now, and that's Aaron Finch's fifth six.
Boy, he's just leant back, battered it back down the ground. Sheer muscle from Finch. Moving up through the gears. Is into the 70s and he is looking good for 100. Incredible striking. 22 runs have just come off that over from Moeen Ali.
Last in there goes 21 from 16. And he's striking them very nicely. It could be four more. Yes, it is. This game is on for Australia.
Remember a 99 World Cup match here, a bloke called Lance Klusner hit a few out in that area, Forney, in an extraordinary game of cricket. This has gone at similar pace, and it's going to be an important role for Ashton Agar. If Australia are going to get home, it's expectations Finch will be the man. Well done there, finding the boundary.
Oh, it's power again from Aaron Finch. It's on a plate from Adil Rashid this time. 84 from 40 for Finch.
Just like the way he's staying really still. Look at that. Nice foundation, nice base.
Well, that's tossed up. Gone high. It's Jordan under it. Great pair of hands. It's a good catch, and that could be game over. Rashid gets his third.
Courageous bowling. Adil Rashid taking pace off, just tempting Finch, challenging. He knows he needs to keep finding the road, but he couldn't get there. He was flighted. Oh, the eyes lit up. He was right in the slot. Just cut across it a little bit. It was a really well-judged catch down there. Jordan. He knew exactly where he was in relation to that boundary line. Well played, Aaron Finch. 84 off just 41. Australia, I think they're in trouble now. 158 for six.
Oh, Andrew Tyne to the action. Second ball into the stands. We've seen some sixes tonight. 18 sixes this evening. Just five runs from this David Willey over. 50 required from 19 deliveries for Australia. Made that 49 from the last three overs. Magnificent bowling from Willey. Just the six runs from it. Got him. Full and straight. Agar walking across to the offside and flick it down past fine leg. And he just misses it.
Terrific bowling. Chris Jordan stepping into it. Successful one-day team. They've got all their momentum and energy up. It's a, could be a challenge coming in just for these one-off games, but he's brought his energy, his enthusiasm, and he gets the job done. The danger man goes. Agar, 29 off 23, 174 for seven.
Kane Richardson. And he's out first ball. Well, if there was any one of those days, Kane Richardson, 0 for 59 with the ball. They dropped to Goober, and he's out first ball.
And throw a little misfield in there too, Vaughan. So, yeah, not the ideal day at the office for Kane Richardson. Well done. It's Jordan. No other option, really, so credit to Richardson that he didn't get selfish. He tried to do the team thing, but three wickets for Jordan. Yeah, the smiles are big, and he's on a hat-trick. Golden Duck, 174 for eight.
Mitchell Sweps in it at number 10. Jordan on a hat-trick. And he did the right thing, full and straight. Two runs and two wickets from this Chris Jordan over. Three for 14, 3.5. And it's a good finish. The three wickets are the key for Chris Jordan. He goes for 42. Australia required 45 from the last two overs. Ah, that's high and handsome from Andrew Tye. That's straight down the barrel.
I don't think it's going to affect the result. A little bit of fun here for AJ Tye. David Willey doesn't see it that way, but it was pace on right in the slot, arch to the back. That's a golf swing.
And again. This time he's going to be out. Liam Plunkett right on the edge. Willey with his first wicket of the night.
Nine down now, Australia. One more for England. Really well-judged catch. Liam Plunkett, tall man. Just knew exactly where he was in relation to that boundary. Well struck by AJ Tye. Just put one right up in the upper deck. That's a good catch, David Willey. It's a breakthrough. Australia, 184 for nine.
That's going to be game over. Plunkett finishes it for England. Tremendous performance. The captain takes the grab.
Yet another brilliant display by this England team in white ball cricket. So well led, Owen Morgan. It's appropriate that he takes the catch to close it out. It's just another all-round wonderful effort. Everyone chipping in. Brilliant crowd in over 24,000. Wonderful scenes. It's a family game. There's grandparents and grandchildren and everyone in between come and enjoy 2020 cricket. And why not when you can watch a team like England has at the moment?
Well, England are just a powerhouse in the white ball game. They've got pretty much everything covered. They put on a great show, a really good team to watch, play the game the right way. It's been a wonderful night's entertainment.
Here's the tale of the tape, the batting for Australia. Short went early, Finch, he finally found his range, and that was a very good innings, but no one really was able to support him. And it always looked like it was a step too far. Big total, 193 all out in the bowling.
Well, all the bowlers managed to get a wicket. He's just got good variations, Owen Morgan, the captain. Moeen Ali had a difficult night. Aaron Finch got hold of him, his economy being 14.5. But the look of Rashid goes for 6.75 once again. And there's the end result. England win the series 1-0 and win this game by 28 runs. Billy Stanlake to get things started for Australia. To Jason Roy. Straight away, he's going to start with a boundary. What a lovely stroke that is.
Oh, well, the carnage continues from the one days for the Aussies. Well, they've started just with the one slip and the short mid-wicket there. You can see him there sneaking in, but look at the wrist work from Jason Roy. Lent on it. So what's the way he gets over the top of this? Just holds the shot. Four runs to start proceedings. Wow.
Well, it looks a beautiful surface to have a bat on. It's dry. No rough follow-throughs at all. These white balls aren't swinging, so you'd expect the batsman to cash in tonight. That's why you see shots like that. Two fours in three balls.
I think Jason Roy's biggest challenge today is going to be holding himself back, Vaughnie, because you've described it. That wicket is a beauty. Perfect cricket conditions. And the ball coming on. It's creative. Didn't get all of it. Look out, if he does, it's going to travel.
Four more. He hits the four every odd number. First ball, third ball, fifth ball. Josh Buttler opening the batting for England T20 cricket. Been in fine form in the 50 overs. Had a really good Indian Premier League this year. Opened the batting six times for the Rajasthan Royals, scored 550s.
Catch!
That's going to be four. The first boundary for Josh Buttler. Bit streaky.
We'll test here for Mitch Swepson. His first T20 game, international standard. He'll be excited by the fact that Buttler wants to take him on. He's in the game, Swepson.
This is going to be a check upstairs. Sharp fielding, quick hands from Alex Carey. The Australians are convinced that Jason Roy's kind of stuck his bat in the ground.
Oh, he's got the foot in. He's all right. He's got in with the foot.
Catch.
Oh, nicely played. Jason Roy. It's a full toss, but the execution of the reverse sweep is absolutely spot on. Josh Buttler down the ground. Mitchell Swepson on T20 debut. He's gone for 16 in his first over. Kane Richardson into the attack. And he's met with a boundary. Jason Roy has moved to 24 from 12 deliveries. It's 37 for naught after 3.1. That's gone high. Has it got long enough? Oh, yes. Yes, it has. It's the second six of the evening.
It's just an all-out assault on this Australian bowling lineup. Buttler, finish off that 100, that match-winning 100.
Kane Richardson's first three balls have travelled. They've gone for 11 so far. Make that 15 from four. Well, England have struck 31 from the last nine deliveries. Make that 35 from 10.
Well, this is not bad bowling here. It's deceived the batsman, caught the big, thick outside edge. But it's a ruthless mindset by the English batsman, and they bring up 50, just 3.5 overs.
Oh, that's baseball style. It's over the top. And it's another boundary. Kane Richardson, welcome into the game. You've gone for 23. We're into the fifth over. And this is the fifth different bowler Australia have used. And it's Andrew Tai, probably the best of the T20 bowlers for Australia. Plenty of variations. Oh, that's going to be out. Oh, he's dropped it. It's Kane Richardson. What a start to the game he's had. Travelled for 23, then drops an absolute goober.
Oh, this is heartbreaking for the Australians. Agar, it's a false stroke. He's just taken that a little bit too easy for mine. And he's out as quick as it went in. It's not good enough from the Australians.
Kane Richardson comes in on the one, and Buttler just whacks it over him. Butler's now 36 from 15. 5 fours, 2 sixes.
5.2 overs, and that's 12 boundaries already. Now, on today, the Englishman.
Oh, that's huge. That's massive. Catch that in the crowd.
At 13 boundaries in 5.3 overs. This partnership just brewing, getting bigger and bigger. It's going to be a long 20 overs for the Australians.
That's going to be the first wicket. No, it's not. No, it's not. Big Billy just couldn't get past Jason Roy.
Well, this tour for Australia is going from bad to worse. Just nothing going right. Big Billy, it's a tall frame. He beats Buttler for pace. Goes high, bottom of the screen. Beautifully shielded by Jason Roy.
Well, I reckon VAR, that's a penalty. Ah, what a strike. That's going to be six. What a shot that is. He's on the back foot here, Josh Buttler.
90 miles an hour. This is courage. This is the modern day cricketer.
Now what a shot that is. Just watch how far Buttler gets over to the offside. The bouncer comes and it brings up Josh Butler's 50 from 22 deliveries. 6 fours, 4 sixes. The quickest 50 that England have had in T20 cricket.
Moving around the crease, another big one from Buttler. Never mind posting a long on, you don't need it.
This is just phenomenal hitting from Buttler again, advancing down, belting it. Didn't quite get it all, but comfortably sails over the man. And that's his fifth six already.
Oh, this one's got the treatment. Has he got enough on it though? No, comfortably taken at head height. And a first international wicket for Mitchell Swepson. Delight for him. More importantly, Australia have got rid of Josh Buttler. A tremendous innings from him. The crowd have been thrilled. The quickest 2020 international 50 by an England batsman. He's holed out. And for Australia, they will breathe a huge sigh of relief as Darcy Short took that catch.
Phenomenal knock from Josh Buttler, deserves all those applause. He made 61 off 30 balls. England 95 for one.
Up and over. Four more for Jason Roy. scoring rapidly. Brings up the England 102.
Yeah, beautiful shot from Jason Roy, showing his power and his form that he's got at the minute.
Here's a quick second. What a wayward throw, a really wayward throw. Four more, thank you very much indeed. Oh dear, the debutant. Actually, he chose the right end to go to, but certainly needed to be on the stumps. Oh, high in the sky, here's a chance, steadying underneath it, and the captain, Aaron Finch, takes the catch. Two down now, England, got rid of both openers. Roy gone, Buttler gone, but they've done some great work with the bat first.
Yeah, good from Big Billy Stanlake, banging it into the surface, change of length, surprise Jason Roy, and a very comfortable catch from Aaron Finch. Great platform for England. Jason Roy has to go for 44. England 108 for two.
Oh, launched over the leg side. Last ball of the 10th over and Owen Morgan crashes his first six of the innings. England at the halfway stage, 116 runs on the board. Morgan's coming up the order ahead of Alex Hales, who he's batting with now. But Morgan came in at three, and he's just kicked that one up beautifully.
So 116 for two at halfway.
So England 116 for two after 10 overs. Five of those 10 have gone for more than 12 runs. England, if they carry on going as they are looking well set to break their own highest 2020 international total. More from Edgbaston after the break. Welcome back to Edgbaston. Owen Morgan and Alex Hales at the crease for England. They're already 116 for two, still 10 overs to go in the innings. Oh, carved away. Four for Hales. This outfield is so fast. He owns three of the highest scores in England 2020 international history. All as an opener, he's come in here at four. Full toss. Smacked away. Nobody on the boundary there. Morgan, four more for England.
Yeah, and that's Kane Richardson. He's gone for 34 in 10 deliveries already. Australia have been poor.
Reverse attempt, skipped it high in the air there. Misjudgment from Morgan, and the catch taken comfortably. Oh, Swepson's got two on his international debut. Couple of big scalps as well. Morgan the latest to go.
Yeah, it's a real strength of Owen Morgan's. Obviously premeditated the early short delivery from Swepson. All he could do was pick out Andrew Ty. Safe catch in the end, and Australia in need a few more of them. Owen Morgan goes for 15, England 132 for three.
Picker from Agar, launched down the ground. Alex Hales plenty on that. Brilliant ball striking, the crowd love it, even the kangaroo loves it.
Yeah, it's a real feature of Alex Hales' batting, those long levers, big extension of the arms and power behind it as well. It's gone all the way.
Oh, delicately played, no third man. Second boundary for Alex Hales, England approaching the 150 mark.
He's renowned for his power hitting, but lovely touch from Hales. Yet again, too much width from Australia.
Joe Root, 9 from 9, needs a boundary. Make that 9 from 10. Now, Johnny Bairstow's waiting in the hutch. With the form that he showed, you could easily have pushed Johnny just one higher up the order. That's going to be his first boundary. Perfect placement.
That's his go-to shot, the slog sweep, and he certainly needed that boundary.
It's a bit streaky from Joe Root. Another boundary nonetheless. Kane Richardson, just look at these figures. 2.1 overs, 0 for 39. Oh, another edge, another boundary. Joe Root scoring fours off the edge. And another edge, and another four. Richardson now's gone for 49 in 2.4. I think he's hit the ground with the bat. Not out, says Alex Worth. Now, Australia have one review. Alex Carey's, right, we'll go for it. Pretty sure he also said that he thinks Alex Hale's hit the ground. Right, he's hit the ground with the bat. As Alex Carey behind the stump said, good decision from Alex Worth, the umpire. Australia lose their review. Powerful struck down the ground, the boundaries aren't huge. The 50 partnership in 28 deliveries. 24 seven sixes.
Yeah, that's brutal power from Alex Hales. That's his 4-4. Too much power for these Australian bowlers.
Oh, that's high. That's high. And that's massive. That's the first tier of this tremendous new stand here at Edgbaston. Alex Hales is 42 from 19 deliveries. We've already seen the record from Josh Buttler today. Can Alex Hales break it? Oh, brilliant from Joe Root. Just the change in the back grip. Getting square onto the bowler, just getting enough on it. He's liking that third man region. Ah, oh, brilliant again from an England batsman. Innovation at its best. You don't see this that often from Alex Hales. He generally strikes it down the ground. Watch the way he gets over to the offside, gets down low early. And on release of the ball, he's very still. Watch this, still on the release. Gives him chance to get those levers going. The 200 up for England. Marcus Stoinis comes in for his first ball, the 19th over. And what a catch, what a wicket. Where's he been hiding?
Well, that's a remarkable catch from Stoinis. His follow through had enough composure to grab it in his right hand. Short delivery, dug into the surface. That is a ridiculous catch. Take a bow, Marcus Stoinis. Alex Hales, 49 of 24 balls. England, 204 for 4.
Johnny Bairstow straight into the action. Six. First ball.
He hits it as hard as anybody. He doesn't waste any time to get going. That was in the slot. First ball. Gone into the stands.
Just two from the first four deliveries of Andrew Tide. Make that two from five in the last over. There's going to be a run out, both at the same end. Brilliant bowling from Andrew Tye. Lots of variations doing for Johnny Bairstow. And it's Joe Root that'll be on his way. Johnny threw the shot too soon. Joe Root takes on the single. Johnny didn't want to go. He jumps back into his crease. He's saying, sorry, Joe, I want to strike it last ball, not you. There you go, watch this. No, I'm getting in. It's like being at school again. In! Joe Root has to go for 35. It's 2-on-5 for 5. And the last ball of the innings. And the last ball's going into Birmingham Town Centre. That's a huge one, the biggest of the night. England end on 221.
Yet again, that was in the slot from Andrew Tai. That was his knuckleball in the slot for Johnny Bairstow. Shows his power again, and that has gone a long way back.
Well, that's why he wanted the last ball, Bairstow. England's second highest T20 score, 221 for five, and there was contributions all down that batting line. At Ryan Buttler, brilliant at the top. Little cameo from Morgan, he changed his position in the order. Hales and Joe Root manoeuvred the ball to 360 degrees around the ground.
Tough day at the office for Australia's bowlers. Flat surface, quick outfield, small boundaries. Agar again, the standout bowler. Those figures and those economies aren't pretty reading.
So there you have it. Australia required 222 to win this only T20 contest. The rate requires 11.1. We'll have the chase after the break.
Well, that's a flashy start there. Darcy Short up against David Willey. They'll know each other from Big Bash challenges, but it's a little bit loose there from Short. Slip taken out, Willie. That's far too straight. Work to the leg side. Jordan does some great work down there on the boundary and keeps it to two. It's the all-round talents, Chris Jordan there. It's not just with ball or bat in hand. It's a complete cricketer. Steady start for the Australians. Jordan working into it and work to the leg side well. Darcy Short. It was straight. It was quick bat speed. Picks off the first boundary. Oh, that's too straight as well from Jordan. And it's good batting. Darcy Short. It's the second boundary. Consecutive balls. And what a way to silence 24,000 people in this ground here.
Yeah, you can see what Jordan's trying to do. He's trying to get the ball very straight to restrict Darcy Short of any width on the offside.
Oh, beautiful stroke, Darcy Short. It's your more traditional cricket shot. It's the overcompensation from Jordan. It's been too straight, got picked for a couple of boundaries, this time through the offside. Oh, taken at short, fine leg. Liam Plunkett. Into the attack, his second ball, immediate impact.
Well, I think Darcy Short will be disappointed with this because you'd rather him get out really having a go and trying to whack it into the stands. This is a nothing shot, really. The cutter from Liam Plunkett, simple catch from Owen Alley. The Australians lose their first wicket. Darcy Short goes for 16. It's 17 for one.
Oh, Aaron Finch getting in on the act now. It was a good over from Plunkett. It got the wicket. Finch's creativity brought about a boundary off the last ball after three overs, 24 for one. Free hit. There's a man at third man and deep backward square. Maxwell carves it down the ground. Well, you can play with freedom there. Is that the ball that launches this attack for the Aussies? Bowled him! The change of pace. Jordan gets the last laugh. Maxwell goes.
Well, 65 miles an hour. A great disguise from Jordan. I think it's like a backspinner. It's an absolute beauty, and the key Maxwell is on his way back to the pavilion.
That's clever bowling, Chris Jordan. Just delivered the no ball, free hit for the four, but comes back. Maxwell goes 10 off seven, Australian trouble, 33 for two. Travis Head is the new man. And this could be trouble. Oh, he's going to get away with a five. Well, what looked like potentially a close run out, you're off the mark with a five.
Well, watch this from David Willey. He He gets a free direct aim at the stumps. And I reckon he misses them from, watch this, into the hand. Perfect position to throw it. And he misses the stumps. But look at that, he misses by 2 metres.
Oh, that's worked nicely by Travis Head. Too straight from Plunkett. That's protection. That man out in the deep, he's more around square leg, worked nicely behind, used the pace. It's the sixth boundary.
Two balls for Travis Head. He's on 9.
Well struck. Aaron Finch, he's just been a little bit frustrated. He was 7 off 7 deliveries, but finally creates something. It was just brute force dispatched over the top from David Willey. Well, that's nicely worked by Finch to the leg side. A little bit wayward there, David Willey. 12 off the over, and Australia just complete their power play with a bit of momentum, 59 for 2. It's been a great start here. Adil Rashid, the first use of spin, just 3 runs from the over into the gap. They'll push to try and get back for 2, but no, well done. Out in the deep by Jordan. It's a good start for the spinner. Just 4 off at 63 for 2.
Oh, this could be a chance. Comfortably taken. Alex Hales with the catch, and Moeen Ali gets a wicket. The first over that he's been brought on. Spin from both ends has brought a bit of pressure, added pressure. And Australia in more trouble, 64 for 3.
Again, just like the ODIs, it's England's spinners doing the damage. Moeen Ali's just been brought into the attack. Travis Head trying to give himself a little bit of room to create the width and elevation. Straight to Alex Hales. Another big wicket for England. Australia 64 for 3.
Very delicately played by Aaron Finch, showing he's got the delicate touch as well as the big hits. He is an important batsman for Australia at this point. Could be the real anchor for their innings. Could be very dangerous if he's still there towards the end.
He's usually renowned for his power hitting. Lovely, deft little touch, beating the man at 45 on his way to the boundary.
Short-lived, and Adil Rashid picks up his first wicket of this match. A highly thought of left-hander, Alex Carey. Got an opportunity at Old Trafford in the one-day series. Touch of turn off the pitch from Adil Rashid. And Australia, well, the situation gets even deeper, 72 for 4. Australia from here still will need another 150 from 70 balls. It's a tough ask. More from Edgbaston as Australia chase down 2-2-2 after the break. Welcome back then to Edgbaston, where Australia have lost 4 wickets in pursuit of 222. They've still got Aaron Finch there. He is a real danger man, but he is rapidly running out of partners as Marcus Stoinis comes out to join him. Roy with the catch. 2 in the over from Adil Rashid. Crowd are enjoying it. Australia very much less so. But England can celebrate. Stoinis gone cheaply. Out for a duck.
Yeah, his poor form continues, doesn't he? Couldn't get the elevation. And a simple catch to Jason Roy. And England's go-to man, Adil Rashid, does it again. Australia 72 for 5.
Oh, he's gone huge. Aaron Finch over deep mid-wicket. First 6. And Australia need a few more of those. The run rate is above 13 and an over from here.
Yeah, that's what you're used to seeing from Aaron Finch. Giving himself a room to free those arms. absolutely belting.
Well, we've already featured Pakistan, Australia and Scotland for you on Channel 5 Cricket this summer. Now Virat Kohli's India are in town. Three 2020 internationals and a series win for England could really help them to climb the rankings there. Then the one-day internationals, and that is number 1v2 in the world. So a tantalising series before five test matches against India wrap up the summer season. Highlights every day on Channel 5. Launched, no question. Ashton Agar, new to the middle. And he has just picked up Adil Rashid beautifully. Hasn't always done well against the spin. In fact, Rashid has dismissed him four times out of five in the one-day internationals. Oh, this is massive. Massive from Aaron Finch. Have Australia got enough time, though, here in this match? They need more than 14 and over. The required rate keeps going up. But suddenly, the sixes are starting to happen for the Aussies.
That's Aaron Finch's second six, and that is well and truly in his arc. Absolutely pummeled.
Oh, thrashed down the ground by Aaron Finch. So much power on it. Meant that Chris Jordan couldn't get there. They've gone past the 100 mark, Australia, but five down and the run rate ever increasing. Aaron Finch is doing his best to bring it down. Oh, high and long. That one reaches the stands. Possibly well caught as well. What a way to bring up your 50. Aaron Finch does it off 27 balls. Australia's still got a glimmer of hope. I reckon they have when this man is in the middle.
Well played. Aaron Finch picked up the length beautifully. Knows that Moeen Ali with this field has to bowl into length. And that's his third six. That's gone miles.
Up and over. Well, Aaron Finch has welcomed Liam Plunkett back into the attack in the most emphatic way. We've had five sixes in just the last 10 minutes. Boundaries are starting to come, the sixes are starting to come. On all off the bat of Aaron Finch. Well, that's been finally struck by Agar. Plenty of power on the shot, get it through the gap.
Yeah, excellent stroke that from Agar, hitting the ball on top of his bounce. Through the offside. Great strike.
Oh, Agar down the ground. Well, they're doing their best to bring the run rate down. It's still sitting at more than 14 and over, though. Oh, full toss, heaved away. No questions asked. Six all the way.
These two have put on 62 now, and that's Aaron Finch's fifth six.
Boy, he's just leant back, battered it back down the ground. Sheer muscle from Finch. Moving up through the gears. Is into the 70s and he is looking good for 100. Incredible striking. 22 runs have just come off that over from Moeen Ali.
Last in there goes 21 from 16. And he's striking them very nicely. It could be four more. Yes, it is. This game is on for Australia.
I remember a 99 World Cup match here. A bloke called Lance Klusner hit a few out in that area, 40, in an extraordinary game of cricket. This has gone at similar pace. And it's going to be an important role for Ashton Agar. If Australia going to get home. It's expectations. Finch will be the man. Well done there, finding the boundary.
Oh, it's power again from Aaron Finch. It's on a plate from Adil Rashid this time. 84 from 40 for Finch.
Just like the way he's staying really still. Look at that. Nice foundation, nice base.
Well, that's tossed up. Gone high. It's Jordan under it. Great pair of hands. It's a good catch, and that could be game over. Rashid gets his third.
Courageous bowling. Adil Rashid taking pace off. Just tempting Finch. Challenging. He knows he needs to keep finding the road, but he couldn't get there. He was flighted. Oh, the eyes lit up. He was right in the slot. Just cut across it a little bit. It was a really well-judged catch down there. Jordan, he knew exactly where he was in relation to that boundary line. Well played, Aaron Finch. 84 off just 41. Australia, I think they're in trouble now. 158 for 6.
Oh, Andrew Tye into the action. Second ball into the stands. We've seen some sixes tonight. 18 sixes this evening. Just 5 runs from this David Willey over. 50 required from 19 deliveries for Australia. Make that 49 from the last 3 overs. Magnificent bowling from Willey. Just the 6 runs from it. Got him. Full and straight. Agar walking across to the offside and flick it down past fine leg. And he just misses it.
Terrific bowling. Chris Jordan stepping into it. Successful one-day team. They've got all their momentum and energy up. It's a, could be a challenge coming in just for these one-off games, but he's brought his energy, his enthusiasm, and he gets the job done. The danger man goes. Agar, 29 off 23, 174 for 7.
Kane Richardson. And he's out first ball. Well, if there was any one of those days, Kane Richardson, 0 for 59 with the ball. They dropped to Gooba, and he's out first ball.
And throw a little misfield in there too, Vaughnie. So, yeah, not the ideal day at the office for Kane Richardson. Well done. It's Jordan. No other option, really. So credit to Richardson that he didn't get selfish. He tried to do the team thing, but 3 wickets for Jordan. Yeah, the smiles are big. And he's on a hat-trick. Golden Duck, 174 for 8.
Mitchell Swepson in at number 10. Jordan on a hat-trick. And he did the right thing, full and straight. Two runs and 2 wickets from this Chris Jordan over. 3 for 40 in 3.5. And it's a good finish. The 3 wickets are the key for Chris Jordan. He goes for 42. Australia required 45 from the last 2 overs. Ah, that's high and handsome from Andrew Tye. That's straight down the barrel.
I don't think it's going to affect the result. A little bit of fun here for AJ Tye. David Willey doesn't see it that way, but it was pace on right in the slot, arch the back. That's a golf swing.
And again. This time he's going to be out. Liam Plunkett right on the edge. Willie with his first wicket of the night.
9 down now, Australia. One more for England. Really well-judged catch. Liam Plunkett, tall man. knew exactly where he was in relation to that boundary. Well struck by AJ Ty. Just put one right up into the upper deck. That's a good catch, David Willey. It's a breakthrough. Australia 184 for 9.
That's going to be game over. Plunkett finishes it for England. Tremendous performance. The captain takes the grab.
Yet another brilliant display by this England team in white ball cricket. So well led, Owen Morgan. It's appropriate that he takes the catch to close it out. It's just another all-round wonderful effort. Everyone chipping in. Brilliant crowd in over 24,000. Wonderful scenes. It's a family game. There's grandparents and grandchildren and everyone in between come and enjoy 2020 cricket. And why not when you can watch a team like England has at the moment?
Well, England are just a powerhouse in the white ball game. They've got pretty much everything covered. They put on a great show, a really good team to watch, play the game the right way. It's been a wonderful night's entertainment.